Many people have asked me for my thoughts on the FCC going up against net neutrality. And really, I mean, you know, they want an episode on that. Can I really just stretch out me saying it's fucking pathetic and this is one of many reasons why America's internet situation is a laughing stock over the course of an 8 to 10 minute episode? I mean, it would be fun, but I don't think there's enough meat there because really, you all know what I think about it. It is fucking pathetic and a joke, and America needs to get its ass in gear because the rest of the world is laughing at it. Fucking putting businesses first. This is where it leads us. The Dark Ages. So there are my thoughts on it. It's an absolute mess. But anyway, we've got to go talk about video games. I'm sure the game industry hasn't done anything stupid and ludicrous and self-defeating lately. Oh wait, it has. In May 2013, Ubisoft announced that Watch Dogs would have a collector's edition. Now, I think the practice of selling a collector's edition of a brand new intellectual property is fucking arrogant at the very best. To me, a collector's edition should be reserved for games that have become established series and have acquired an actual fan base. You know, earn some credibility first before appealing to an audience that may not be there. So, Watch Dogs getting a collector's edition is, to me, a bit silly. And then I remember that Ubisoft didn't actually just announce one collector's edition, it announced five. Fucking five. Yes, Watch Dogs has a DedSec, Vigilante, Uplay, Special, and Limited Edition all in the works, and the sheer ludicrousness of this behaviour was exemplified with a spreadsheet that's been going around lately to help people work out what edition might come close to giving them what they want. Operative word, close, because I doubt that with five editions and exclusive content dispersed among them, anybody will get the version of Watch Dogs that has all the stuff they want. I mean, look at this table! Fucking look at it! Can we all agree, really, please, that this isn't at least a little bit fucking ridiculous? This is too much! Too fucking much! Something like this is as anti-consumer as it gets. When you need a fucking spreadsheet in order to work out what video game you want to buy, you're dealing with a practice that is not putting your convenience and satisfaction first, not even a distant second. How can it be? I've already seen fans frustrated at best and utterly confused at worst over which of the five fucking editions and the chaotic mess strewn about them is good for them. Confusing and alienating your consumer base is not good. How is that ever good? I am sure Ubisoft would toe the EA company line of claiming it's offering choice to its consumers, but that's fucking bullshit. There's no customer benefit in dividing a game's content into little pieces and ostensibly trying to get fans to buy more than one overpriced copy of a game if they want everything. Where is the choice to play content without it being held ransom by GameStop as an exclusive pre-order bonus? Where's the choice to have developers stop wasting fucking time and resources working on all the ways to squeeze some extra money out of gamers before they've even finished making the damn fucking game? If publishers are so pro-choice, can I choose that last option? Can I choose the option where yet more time and money isn't utterly fucking wasted on the convoluted contrivance of five special editions? Games are no longer games. They're territories, carved up and handed over to individual warlords. GameStop, Amazon, Steam, and whatever proprietary digital service the publisher decided to pull out of its own arse, they're all served long before the customer is, each one getting a slice of the game in the form of exclusive pre-order content or whole new versions. In doing so, companies split their own audience up and divide them into camps, months, maybe even years ahead of the actual game's launch. Our wallets not only prized open directly, but traded on like cattle to the physical and digital retail masters whom the publishers truly serve. Publishers don't just sell their games to you, they sell you, their customers, to other companies. And the result is confusion among gamers, not to mention further encouragement for gamers to just say fuck it, ignore it at release, and wait for the inevitable Game of the Year edition, something that'll be a lot more complete, a lot easier to track the content of, and probably way fucking cheaper. And this industry wonders why it's in trouble.
I mean, Jesus. I'm not saying Kingdoms of Amalur was ever going to be a success, but when you remember how poorly that game performed, and then remember it had a $200 special fucking edition with a statue and everything, you start to realise just how fucked in the head this inane, unfettered, cart before horse putting business truly is. It was a new IP! This is hot off the heels of Far Cry 4's pre-order bonus being announced in tandem with Far Cry 4, to the point where I heard the pre-order news before I saw the news about the game itself, and all the fucking Arkham games having full swathes of content sectioned off for sale as pre-order DLC long before the titles themselves go gold. Content that used to be free, don't forget, before pre-order culture took over, and the once cool idea of the collector's edition has been completely and utterly fucking devalued. And had all the prestige sucked out of it through overuse, exploitation, abuse, and ugly fucking troll statues in Kingdoms of Amalur. Five collector's editions, though. Five. Five! Fuck's sake, game industry. Restrain yourself.
As with so many things in the game industry, I like it at its core, like I like DLC at its core. I like the core idea of a collector's edition, but this is ridiculous! Five collector's editions for a new IP? It's bloody stupid. Once again, a great idea, something in theory I'm behind, has been utterly abused and exploited and rendered into some weird mutant joke to the point where I have to stand against it in totality on sheer principle. Thanks a lot, game industry. Thanks, 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 thanks. Thank God for me, and thanks. Before we go, there are some more stuff what people sent me very kindly on my Amazon's wish list and stuff. I don't get my tits out on camera to get that stuff, which makes it extra heartwarming for me. Although if you do want to see them, you know, I'm sure I'll be at some future event and we can go into the toilets and I can flop them out. But anyway, some notes came with some of them. Some of them were sent anonymously, so I can't say a thank you. But all sorts of childish aliens things and Metal Gear Solid toys and all these babyish items. But the notes I have, I hope I've got them all and didn't lose any. Just give out some thanks for that. So thanks to Yazan B and that's just a thing. Peter A. Jacob, Oliver Sadler, and Ryan Canyard. And thank you for all the lovely notes that came with them. That's often the best part of it. So thanks. And, you know, to those of you who sent stuff where there are no notes, or maybe I lost some like a dick, apologies for that. But thank you for that. It's really nice, and it makes me feel a little bit appreciated and stuff, which is always nice. So thank God for you. But mostly me.